No, no, absolutely not. I told you 30, tops. Who? Yeah, sure, if she's 30, I'm 26. Well, maybe, but Kimber, Kiki, and Fawn are my picks. Gotta go. You're Samantha Collins.
Nice to meet you.
I don't shake hands. Can you see without those?
Oh, not really, but I only use
them. Yeah, no, that's no good. Gerard!
Get reading contacts.
Stand up for me, please. Turn around. Yeah, no, her clothes are out of a John Hughes movie and the hair needs a total makeover.
Hideous clothes, new do.
And we'll have to talk about a face or brow lift and maybe a boob lift as well.
Face, brow.
No, excuse me,
maybe a hair extension too.
Oh, no, no, I'm not getting anything lifted or extended.
I'm sorry, did you not see all the photos of married couples in my lobby? I think I know what's best.
Do you only make matches for Playboy bunnies and models, or are regular women like me?
I think I see where this is going, Miss Married for 15 years, but I'm here to tell you it's a whole new world out there. This is L.A. And men here don't want middle-aged women to date. They want young, hot babes, and honey, you ain't that. I like you, Samantha. You have spunk, but if you want me to help you, you have to let me do my thing.
I just know that I have a lot to offer, and I think maybe you and I together could...
No offense, but as far as I can see, you don't. Gerard! I don't normally take the time, but in your case, sit back and don't move. And start right there.
The bone's so deep right there.
Don't complain.
It's spurting.
Get a Band-Aid.
Should I get some Pinkberry?
Sure.
Oh, she looks like Kelly Clarkson.
That just about does it. Come back after you've made those changes and we'll talk.
Wow. Oh, okay. Thanks for your time.
Excuse me.
You know, no offense, but if I have to surgically alter parts of my body to work with you, I'd rather not. I know that my perfect mate is out there, but if I did what you said, he'd never recognize me. If I can't have somebody who will just accept me for who I am, a loving human being who enjoys everything in life, from poetry readings in a coffee house to scuba diving off the coast of Belize, well then, I'd just rather be alone for a while. Thank you very much. Have a nice day. What a disaster. At least I have my writer's group to look forward to this afternoon. Benny Pittman.
Hey, Sam. Hey, Marlo. Samantha Collins, this is Jake Haggerty. He's a writer friend of mine. I didn't think you'd mind if he tagged along.
Hi.
Hi. Thanks. Anyone who brings chocolate is always welcome here. Come on in.
Told you she was easy.
I heard that. So, Jake, what do you write?
Nonfiction, mostly. In fact, I just got back from Belize. I was researching an article there.
For Reuters.
Oh. Well, I can't wait to read it.
I can't wait to show it to you. But today, I brought my poetry.
Poetry, too? When do you have time to sleep?
Wait till she hears you sing and play.
Guitar, acoustic, mostly.
Well, is there anything you don't do?
Dance.
Oh, bummer.
I mean, I don't get the opportunity to dance all that much, really, anymore.
Well, maybe you just haven't found the right partner.
Maybe I haven't.
I dance. All styles. Hip-hop's my specialty, but...
Great. Oh, you two just make yourselves at home. I gotta finish feeding Marlo.
Acoustic.
Hip-hop's my specialty.
Whatever.
Which brings me to rule number two of dating in the Middle Ages. Always have your Grace Kelly face on, because you never know when you'll run into the perfect Cary Grant.